So if you remember in our Universal Encyclopedia of Scales, we map out for you guys all 2048 scales in music. So a bunch of people are asking us, well, how do you know it's exactly 2048? How do you know there aren't more? How do you know it's not too many? Well, today we're gonna talk about how we figured out this exact number, and we're gonna use the circle of fifths to show you that. If you're new to MDEX Music, we create music books and apps, piano arrangements, and we discuss improvisation, songwriting, and sometimes we take music theory to strange and uncharted places. So subscribe and hit the bell and join us for exclusive access to our ever-expanding library of music resources. So here we have our handy dandy circle of fifths with a C at the 12 o'clock position. What we're gonna do is graph the C scale on top of this circle of fifths, get a very unique shape, and show you how that shape will find us the answer to that original question. So I'll just kind of like plot out here all the notes relevant to the C scale. And you can see I just kind of go around the circle of fifths to find all these notes, and then there's the F over here. So there are all the notes I might find in a C scale in the circle of fifths. Now if I just connect these dots together, I'll get that graph or that very specific shape that I was talking about over here. And then I gotta go all the way across, right there. So what I have here is basically the major scale's shape. Here is the major scale graphed onto the circle of fifths. And I could have any note at 12 o'clock. I could have D at the 12 o'clock position, and now I have the D major scale, or G, or F. But what you'll notice is that the shape does not change because, well, a major scale is a major scale. There's only one major scale. So kind of what we're looking at here is a scale formula, right? There's only one whole tone scale, and that would give us a very different shape. Now, whether we can or whether we should consider transposing those scales into all 12 or 15 keys. That's right, I said 15. If you want to understand that more, check out this video where we react to Victor Wooten's 15 scale theory. Whether we want to do that to get another number altogether, we'll get into later. So yes, that means using our definition, any two notes or any interval can be considered a scale. So if I have the tritone interval or scale, that's what it looks like graphed on the circle of fifths, just like a straight line across. Or if I wanted to do a power chord or a fifth rather, it's just a straight line across the graph in that direction now. Let's do, I don't know, what if we had an augmented triad? That's a good one, because it just creates a nice symmetrical shape, triangle. And that really reinforces the idea of symmetry in our scales. When you see them graphed over the circle of fifths, all these properties get exposed to us. Okay, so now that you understand how graphing scales onto the circle of fifths works, let's take the next step. That's going to be the first step into understanding our proof for how we got to 2048. So as you can see, it put the C scale back on the circle of fifths. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create sort of a binary fingerprint or barcode or number, if you will, that lets us associate this scale formula with that scale type, irrespective or irregardless of what the root is. This is a major scale's serial number. All right, here we go. This is how we're gonna do that. I'm gonna put a one next to every note, starting at 12 o'clock, that is in the scale, and then a zero next to any note that is not featured in the graph or the scale. So what I do now is I just write that over here as a 12-digit number, starting with, again, C, our 12 o'clock note, our root, and I'm gonna get this. I'm gonna get 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, is that 6? Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I got 5 zeros in a row, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then that F over there, 1. So now we have here a very unique number that's specific to just the major scale type, or the major scale formula, if you will. All major scales will look like that. And we can do this for any scale type. We can do this for any scale formula. So here we have melodic minor. Let's look at melodic minor's unique binary number here. So now we would have 1, 1, 1, 1. Now we have 4 ones in a row. two, three, four, a zero, one again for the B, three more zeros, one, two, three, a one, a zero, and well, that should be a one also. Boom. So there we have our melodic minor expressed using that binary system that we talked about. So here we have the whole tone's binary number and the augmented triad's binary number. So if you stuck with us so far, congratulations, it's about to start making sense. Here's what we're gonna do now. We have these 12 digits or these 12 columns, and what I'm gonna do is just block off this first one because, well, it's always gonna be a one. There always has to be a root, all right? So we're gonna set that aside as something uniquely, consistent. It's always there, we always need a root. And what that leaves us with is 11 other columns. So basically what I have here is 2, and then I have 11 other choices to the power of 11. There's 2 options within that first column, or any column really, so there's our 2, and I have 11 different choices to pick and choose from as it relates to whether there is a 1 there or whether there is a 0. And when I create that exponential, I get, well, you guessed it, 2048. There are 2048 scale formulas in music. So the number of scale formulas in music will always be 2048. That's why we know we have all of the scales in music within the Universal Encyclopedia of Scales. Also, we can find all related modes by grouping the scales with shifted binary codes. And we can also find symmetric scales because they have fewer modes than notes, which means there are fewer binary codes than notes in the scale. So just one more point of clarification before I let you go. You may have noticed, or as I alluded to earlier in the video, I said there's only one type of major scale. There's only one type of whole tone scale. So if we want to, I guess basically, for those of you who want to know, how many different scales do I have to learn? How many different muscle memory patterns am I going to have to sort out on my instrument to get through all the scales in music? All you would have to do is take the number we came up with, you multiply that by the 12 tones or pitch classes in music, and that's how you would sort out, not that there are merely 2048 scale formulas in music, but how many scales there were actually to learn on your voice or instrument, and you would see 24,576. So 2048 scale formulas times 12, 24,576 scales. There you have it. Hope all that made sense. Congratulations to you if it did. If you want to learn more about the Universal Encyclopedia of Scales, check out our website and grab your copy today. You can get it in hardcover or in PDF format. And of course, all members of our channel will get free supplemental material based on today's lesson. If you're not a member and would like to become one, just click on the join button or the link down below. If you have a different take on our 2048 scale formula proof, let us know in the comments down below, and we're more than willing to hear you out. Thanks again for watching. Catch you next time. So you were saying that there are scales with less modes than notes? Correct, there are scales with less modes than notes. We call these symmetric scales, or scales of limited transposition.
Limited transpositions?
Yeah, never mind that now. Do you remember earlier how we got all the related modes of a scale by using the circle?